I became interested in the brain as an undergraduate at Northwestern University. I had taken a lot of science courses and I knew that I was good at science, but nothing had really grabbed me until I took a course on the biological basis of psychology, basically to fill a distribution requirement in social sciences. And we had a fantastic professor, Arya Rutenberg, who made the brain come alive for many students in the class, and I was completely hooked and actually went on with a few of the other undergraduates to work in his laboratory for several years, and I think that was a big part of what pushed me to apply to graduate school. I think that plasticity is important for everything. Without plasticity, brains would be hardwired. We wouldn't be able to develop from infancy. We wouldn't be able to change over time, to develop new interests, to learn, to do any of the things that really make us human. So plasticity is really embodies everything about the human experience. Glutamate receptor trafficking is relevant to many types of plasticity in the brain. It's interesting that until about 15 years ago, we didn't even know that glutamate receptors did traffic, in other words, move between the synapse and intracellular compartments. Prior to that, people thought of synapses as fixed, just waiting for a neurotransmitter to be released and then they would respond. But the discovery that these receptors were very mobile led to the first real understanding of how a synapse's experience, in other words, the level of activity that it experienced, could very rapidly produce a change in synaptic strength, either by recruiting more glutamate receptors to the synapse or removing them. It's now clear that this is a mechanism that regulates synaptic strength all over the brain, and of course in the reward pathways as well that are important for drug addiction. I think that the crowning jewel or accomplishment of any career is to participate in bringing a therapeutic drug to clinical use. And what would make me happiest is if I could combine my enjoyment of working out puzzles at the synaptic level with efforts to utilize that knowledge to develop therapies that could be used to help recovering drug users remain abstinent, then that would be a perfect combination for me, and I would be very, very happy.